Welcome to Crazy News. My name is Shweta Sinha and now take a look on today's headlines. PM Modi reviews 8 projects, One Nation, One Ration Card scheme. The inside story of Kabul Airport, pay 3,000 for a water bottle, rupees 7,000 for plate of rice. 45% rise in COVID-19 cases overnight in Hyderabad. Santa clears online name sent by Collegium for elevation to Supreme Court. All party meet today, EMS Jaishankar to brief floor leaders. Chairing the 37th Pragati meeting, Prime Minister Narendra Modi on Wednesday reviewed 8 projects having cumulative cost of 1.26 lakh crores and spanned over 14 states, as well the One Nation, One Ration Card scheme.
While reviewing the ONORC scheme, he asked officials to explore the multiple utilities of the technology platform developed under the program to ensure the provision of a wide array of benefits to the citizens. Commenting on the projects, Modi stressed on the significance of their timely completion. Pragati is the acronym for ICT-based multi-model platform for proactive governance and timely implementation involved in the center and the state governments. Among the 8 projects, 3 each were from the Ministry of the Railway and Ministry of the Road Transport and Highways, and 2 were from the Ministry of Power. The states covered under them are Uttar Pradesh, Madhya Pradesh, Punjab, Himachal Pradesh, Gujarat, Rajasthan, Maharashtra, Haryana, Chhattisgarh, Arunachal Pradesh, Sikkim, Uttarakhand, Manipur, and Delhi, the PM said. The Prime Minister also directed the state official to keep monitoring the construction of oxygen plants and availability of hospital beds. It said, adding that in previous 36 Pragati meetings, 292 projects have a total cost of rupees 13.78 lakh crore have been reviewed.
Kabul Airport, where the condition is deteriorating as the deadline for evacuation, that is August 31st, is coming closer.
At present, there are thousands of people gathered outside the Kabul airport. It is estimated that about 10 lakh people want to leave the country, but till this evening, only 82,300 people were evacuated. Most of these people were foreign citizens or who possess a visa of some other countries. The common people of Afghanistan are waiting for their turn outside the airport in the hell-like situation. Many of these people today tried to pass through a dirty drain to enter the airport. It is difficult for any person to stand even for 10 minutes in the path of airport, but these people have been standing there for the last several days. There are many people who do not have money left for buying water or food. The water that is available outside the airport is so expensive that most people cannot even think to buy it. The cost of a water bottle outside the Kabul airport is up to $40, that is about 3,000 rupees, whereas of a plate of rice people have to pay $100, that is over 7,000 rupees. To make things worse, only those people who have US currency can get this water and food. The situation is terrible indeed. According to the media report, more than 50,000 people are still waiting outside the Kabul airport. Because of this, there are such a terrible jam that reaching the airport is near impossible task. The process of evacuating continuously night and day. A large number of people have gathered on the runway who wanted to get out of Afghanistan by any means. These people were among those lucky enough to be allowed inside the airport. Outside the airport, the situation is worse, where thousands of people are waiting to go inside. While there is hope and happiness on one side of the airport wall, there is a helplessness and misfortune on the other side. In the massive crowd, no one is afraid of the coronavirus infection. The only fear is from the Taliban.
COVID-19 cases raised by 45% overnight, the Hyderabad city and the rest of the GHMC area, with the health department saying that on Wednesday, 102 new cases were discovered in the greater.
On Tuesday, the department reported 70 new cases in GHMC area. The last time 100 or more cases were reported in Hyderabad was on July 4 this year, when 107 cases of COVID-19 were found. With the government opening all sectors and allowing full freedom to the people to move about and go about their daily lives, several doctors have been expressing concern over the past few weeks that careless behavior by people could well result in another spurt in cases leading to the third wave of COVID-19 in the state. While Wednesday's steep jump in COVID-19 case in Hyderabad could be an isolated development, the sudden rise come barely a week before all education institutions are set to open fully in the city and the rest of the state. Meanwhile, the department said that two more people dead from COVID-19 in the state, taking the death toll so far to 3,864, while the 366 fresh cases on Wednesday took to 6,56,098, the overall cases.
The center is learned to have approved all 9 names recommended by the Supreme Court Collegium for appointments as judge in the Apex Court.
The government has now forwarded the list to President Ram Nath Kovind for issuance of warrants of appointment. Now the president formally approves the center's decision, the new judge will be sworn in. The Supreme Court is currently functioning with 24 judges against a sanctioned strength of 35. The approval will fill 9 vacancies, taking the work strength to the 33. Last week, the Supreme Court had officially announced that its collegium has recommended to the center 9 names, including 3 women High Court judges, for appointing them as a judge of Apex Court. The recommendation by the Supreme Court's 5-member collegium headed by CJI N.V. Raman ended the 21-month-long logjam over the appointment of new judges to the Apex Court.
The External Affairs Minister S. Jaishankar will brief the floor leaders on the situation in Afghanistan after the Taliban seized power in the war-ravaged country.
The center has called for all parties meeting on Thursday morning to discuss the Afghanistan situation. The decision to call an all-party meeting comes after the opposition parties asked the center to issue a statement on the Afghanistan crisis. The meeting will be attended by the leader of opposition in the Lok Sabha, Adhir Ranjan Chaudhary, and the LOP in Rajya Sabha, Mallikarjun Kharge, as well. The meeting comes at the time when the government of India has evacuating people from Afghanistan as the Taliban entered the Afghan capital on August 15 and declared its victory over the government. Earlier, on August 17, India has announced that it would issue an emergency e-visa to Afghan nationals who want to come to the country in the view of prevailing situation in Afghanistan after the Taliban captured power there. Additionally, Union Minister Hardeep Singh Puri revealed that India has evacuated 626 people, including 228 Indian citizens, from Afghanistan till Tuesday. 626 people, including 228 Indian citizens, have been evacuated from the Afghanistan till now. The number of Afghanistan Sikhs who have been evacuated is 77, Puri had informed earlier.
That's it from me and my team. For more updates, keep watching Crazy News.